Imagine a time long ago in man's distant past. When he first discovered the subtle force that moves the needle of the compass. This discovery enabled man to navigate and discover new horizons. The ancients are portrayed as ignorant and superstitious. So how do you imagine man related to this simple magnetic force? He probably seen it as a great magical intelligence, for by its guidance, man could find his way across seas, deserts, and wilderness. It was with the aid of this discovery that man overcame many superstitions. You know that is only a short time in our history that we've moved beyond the illusion that the world was flat. But in order to make real benefit of this discovery, man had to employ a cross. Man noticed that the four directions, north, south, east, and west, had an alignment to the four seasons. And this natural sympathetic alignment also aligned to the four elements of nature: fire, water, air, and earth. These things represented great spiritual forces to the primitive man. But the most supreme force for man was the force that made the compass move. For it was the force that gave him guidance. He called it the spirit. He could see this spirit in nature, for there is an intelligence in nature that continually makes adjustment to suit the season. The animals mate, some migrate, some change their coat to suit the seasons. The plants too made adjustments to suit the seasons. Man observed that this adjusting force was indeed wise, and it showed compassion for its creatures. Man discovered that in his dream life, guidance was sometimes given. Therefore, he deducted that the same spirit was present and active in the dream world. He discovered that if he followed certain feelings in his being, it would guide him. He called this intuition. He discovered that at times ideas would appear in his mind that were of benefit to him. And with these things, man realized he had a relationship with this most benevolent of forces. Man observed that there were at times disorderly forces in nature that did not appear to be of the same benevolent nature as the spirit of benevolence he called Lord. The forces that were in reverse to the spiritual Lord of life he called evil. And because these forces were destructive, they made things that were alive become those that once lived. He called what he thought was the master of evil forces the devil. For that which was alive now only once lived. Man also observed that there were destructive or evil forces inside him that were the same by nature as the forces of nature. These forces did not bring benefit, as did the force he called Lord. So he set about on a journey with his inner compass to find his Lord. He discovered many things would give him guidance. The stars in the sky, the bringer of messages to the mind, These were occult forces. And through these forces, man discovered reality. Thank you.